All right, we're back with our Skyward Sword walkthrough. Just got the goddess sword and basically got the stone tablet, which opened up a place in the clouds. And Link got his threads, and that's what I'm talking about. That's what you're supposed to look like, Link. It's kind of freaky that a guy's staring at you the whole time while you change clothes, but... color, huh? But seeing you in it, you're born to wear it, that's for sure. Looks a green man. If you leave the room and come back in, they won't be there, but after a while, if you check there, you'll get 5 more rupees, so. And now your buddy out here.
Hey!
So yeah, you get a venture pouch in this game, which is different than typical Zelda. You hit the minus button, and you can actually carry, like, your shield takes a spot in here, and so do any bottles. So you can only carry so much with you at a time. Eventually you unlock 8 of them, you unlock all the corners too, or the diagonals. But it is different. Someone else's bird, that's why. Yeah. Grease won't come out of his room, he's sulking. So we'll leave his Grease to his sulking in his room. He's basically just crying to himself about how Zelda's missing and blah blah blah. So. Save. Talk to this guy here.
No.
Which is nice. So here's your adventure pouch, and now we got your shield in it, so you just let go, and now you got your shield. Shield is used with the nunchuck. Now you can see in the top left under your hearts, it actually has a meter, and every time you take a hit, it goes down, unless you perfectly shield bash it, and then you won't lose durability. And you learn to do it. When I started the game, the first one I got actually broke, so I had to eventually buy a new one. shouldn't have that problem in this one. You never know, though. He said to go talk to the, I have a shield. Thank you. So basically, you see on the right there, you have the Wiimote on the screen. That's based on this interface, which is standard. You can go to light, and it only shows a few buttons. Not the whole thing. And then you can actually go to pro, which shows nothing. I'm going to do pro since I know the controls. Keep more screen open. There's a little slowdown. There's going to be slowdown, because it's running, like I said, on the Dolphin on my computer, so. So that's how you roll into the trees to get some cash. So you said to go to the bazaar. Now, because you talked to that guy, you got a shield, or else you'd have to buy a shield. So that saves you some money. Now, here's your bazaar. These guys, every once in a while, they'll have a speech bubble on their head. And you actually get a few. Side quests by talking to them at the right time. This guy tells you you can sleep, and at night it's a different place. Any bed in the game you can sleep in. I didn't know that. I always ran back to Link's bed, but I didn't walk in anyone's house, so sleep in their bed to make it night. Bye! This guy, if you want, and get your fortune told. Basically, it gives you a hint, like if you're going to an area, you should, you know, if you go to a fire area, don't take a wooden shield. If you're going to, you know, somewhere else, don't take this. So, this is your guy for upgrades.
Oh, yeah!
The scrap shop. So, if your shield is low, you can fix it for 10 rupees. As long as it's not broken, it only costs 10, which is a lot cheaper than buying a whole new one. And then you go to upgrade gear. Anything you have on you that you can upgrade. So, to upgrade your shield, you need one monster claw, we got three. One jelly claw, we got that, but we don't have any amber relics yet. Once we get two of those, we can upgrade it. And what an upgrade shield does is it looks different. And it also has a higher durability. So yeah, your durability goes up more, so it's nice. This is your item check girl.
Hi.
Who is very bored in the beginning, but she warms up to you. And what you can do here is, because you can only carry so much stuff, you have to move some into storage if you want to carry something else, and you don't have the room, so, of course, we only have one now. This guy is your basic seller. He's hilarious, too. If you run up to him, he's all happy. And then if you run away from him, he gets sad. There's really no reason to buy any of this stuff, because you will find them in the world, so. Now she's got a thing on her head, you definitely want to come here and talk to her.
Yeah.
Even if you don't plan on buying a potion, you want to talk to her, because she will give you a bottle. Your first bottle of the game.
Hmm?
Yes, it is. So we got good. This is Guardian Potion. It's 200 rupees, and it actually makes it so you only take half health for 3 minutes, and you can upgrade it so you can actually take no health, take no damage. And you can upgrade it to get no damage. This is Revitalizing Potion, which gives you a few hearts back and restores your shield all the way. This is Air Potion. You can't buy it yet, but it helps you breathe underwater. This is your health potion, which refills 8 hearts, and then you can upgrade it to refill all your hearts, and then you can upgrade that one again, that potion, to have 2 uses, and it upgrades all your hearts. So that's actually not bad to get in time. You can't do it yet, though. And this is Stamina Potion, which helps your stamina won't go down for so long. She actually doesn't sell it, so we're not going to buy any of these now, because... We're actually going to get another bottle full of this revitalizing stuff relatively soon. And this guy is the guy who upgrades your potions. If you buy a potion, you talk to him, and you use the bugs you get to upgrade them so they're stronger. So that's the Bazaar. Back here is a... It's a goddess chest, and eventually when you get to the goddess cubes and you unlock them, different chests around the world will glow and you can open it. So you can open it until you find the goddess cube that, you know, corresponds to it. So it'll be a while before you open that one. That's really all you need to do in here. You don't need to buy a potion, but you definitely get the bottle. That is Beetle. He has a shop as well. I remember Beetle from Wind Waker. But you need a slingshot or an arrow or something. You hit that bell, and then he'll stop, lower a rope down, and take you up there. You can get a lot of stuff up there that's good. You can get more adventure pouch slots. You can get bigger wallets, and you can get a piece of heart, actually, which is something that you'll definitely want to get. It's expensive though, you won't be able to get it for a while. And you also have to buy something that's expensive before it even sells the piece of heart. So there's really nothing else to do here. There's no side quests yet until you get through the first area. So we'll come back later. Basically, you just want to just get to the world. So we're going to stop here. This is a good save point. And finally, start the game proper. It's a long intro to this game, but we are to the point where we will start doing stuff besides running around here. So in the next one, we'll head down to the surface. So we'll see you in the next one.